1974, the controversial filmmaker Sir Leslie Quint's situation looked desperate.
You know that phrase, if you can remember the 70s, then you weren't actually there? Well, in my case, it was more of, if you were in a Thai prison, then you don't remember the 70s, but you were actually there, which isn't quite as catchy.
While searching for his missing mail order bride in Thailand, Leslie had been incarcerated in the maximum security prison known as the Bangkok Hilton.
Well, it certainly didn't resemble any Hilton I'd been in before. At first, when I got in, I thought they were just redecorating. But it was very much a prison, and when I realized this, my heart sank. But then, when I saw who I was bunking down with, my heart soared. Some lovely chaps.
To Leslie's surprise, far from the nightmare he had anticipated, his imprisonment at the Bangkok Hilton proved something of a revelation, and he began to cherish life again.
I very much enjoyed the company of my fellow inmates, regular showers, no questions asked. Occasionally, a crazy person would attack you in the night. But on the whole, we all just found a way to get on, you know, as men in confined spaces tend to do.
In arguably the boldest move of his life, Leslie chose to remain in custody for a further 4 years after his sentence had been served.
When I decided to stay, some of the other inmates thought it was a bit rum because, they wanted to leave. But I thought it was a place where I could finally be alone with my thoughts. Sometimes they'd beat me and spit in my gruel, but I often found I could smooth things over with a few anecdotes, and I made some lovely, lasting companions there.
Leslie emerged from the Bangkok Hilton in 1981, and he immediately returned to London, keen to regenerate his film career. Thatcher's Britain seemed to be beckoning him.
Thatcher was very hard and very mean. But that's what England needed in the 80s, you know? A damn good slap. Plus, she was able to galvanize the art community in only the way that shared hatred can muster. And I really wanted to be a part of that.
But Leslie's ambition to resuscitate his career faced one major challenge. Despite a prolonged absence overseas, his previous work still lingered in the memory of Britain's film community, as well as the controversy, commercial failure, and outright vitriol that trailed in its wake.
Well, at first I was flattered that everyone still remembered me. I mean, who wouldn't be? But when I realized that it was for all the wrong reasons and that I was very much loathed still, well, that was unfortunate.